ga het gewoon
Succes.
Doen.
Succes.
And in front of the camera we have Tess Rutgers, founder of the Value Track Method, a special method to bring together all kinds of stakeholders and entrepreneurs, right, Tess? Welcome.
Thank you very much, Lieke.
Well, thank you very much for being here. The Value Track Method, could you in a few sentences explain what it is?
It's a method, actually, where you can funnel from a collective value case. So why is this an innovation we all want? And then trigger, why is it not there yet? And based on that, we understand what is the call to action in order to realize market breakthroughs, mainly with multiple stakeholders. It's never just a one-on-one, although that matching happens too, but it's merely like groups of stakeholders who really say, okay, we're going to do this and we're going to make it happen.
And it's rather difficult, I think, because if you have different stakeholders, you have different interests for people and different ways of looking at things.
That's true. But we actually realize like a 360 stakeholder loop, and the kickoff is always, do you think this is really important? And then you can see that all the stakeholders are interlinked. And that means you have a common goal. And as soon as they understand this is a common goal, then there's also a win-win for everyone to be involved. And it's very intriguing how things start off and, you know, they are triggered. And based on that, people make their own connections. So it's a very natural way to establish these networks around these calls to action.
Okay, so and here today at the European Roundtables, we've seen four value track sessions, actually. Could you elaborate a little bit on them? Which four are there?
There's personalized medicine and treatment. There's energy storage. There's space wisdom for smart cities. And there is people flows. And one of the other things that are really nice is that these themes are not because we chose them. This is also based on people who said, hey, I've got this idea. I think I can, you know, gather more of these stakeholders to actually get involved. And this is how it comes loose. And then if everybody agrees, yes, we are in, there is a collective value here, then that's where it starts off.
And you think that today was a success? Did they find each other?
Yeah. Oh, it was brilliant. Yeah. It was really funny because in the beginning, obviously, we start these sessions and, you know, we are prepared for 50%, but then there's this other 50% where you never know what's going to happen. And what happened today is there's like a chain reaction. You know, people stand up and then they sit down and then the next one comes in and then via the chat, they, you know, come up with all kinds of resources. So we've actually seen, and this is the most important thing, that it's a chain reaction during the session, but it also means that afterwards people are going to follow up. So one of the entrepreneurs said, I'll make sure there's a workshop and I'll host it. Okay. And so the stakeholders can join up. And then a big corporate is saying, okay, from our perspective, we've got this think tank, please join up. And then the next one comes up with their own event. So actually there's a common thread build up along these events, and every time we can expand the network, or sometimes it's getting smaller, but it doesn't matter. It's all about the dynamics and the reflection of the people themselves.
Okay, so a lot of energy came through today.
Yeah, and what is amazing. Cool as well, there are like crossovers. So what's happening in people flows with, for example, ID standardization. There's also a link to be made when you look at, for example, personalized medicine. Yeah. So that's, and then you already understand who was in that network, like a little eco network, around this call to action. And you could say, okay, these five stakeholders, why don't you guys also join in this other value track? Because we can leverage each other's knowledge and insights.
Yeah, so, exactly. Because a lot of have the same issues and the same calls to action, actually.
Yeah.
What are the main calls to action?
Most of the time it's because of digitalization. So what you see is it's a really complex world. So if you want to innovate there, you can't do it all in one go. That's not going to happen. And everybody agrees with that. So there are more than one initiatives in that sense. But you can learn from each other. And one day this will all get together. But that's when it's over and done with. And the whole transition, as everybody calls it, is actually coming to an end.
Okay, clear. So there's a lot to be done yet for the future.
Yeah.
We're working towards October. There are other events as well. Also value tracks there, I think.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And now we did it like in a smaller, more regional, more national setting, though there were a lot of people from abroad dialing in and being online. But then in October, it's going to be very much focused on expanding this network from a European standpoint, and then call out to the rest of the world, hey guys, why global. Don't you join in? Yeah. And then it would be great, obviously, if in January 2022, we could actually, you know, do this on a global scale, because it's worthwhile. And all these themes of the value tracks, they're like, you know, they can be applicable globally.
Yeah. And we need each other, actually. Yeah, we should not invent the wheel all for ourselves, but work together.
Totally, yeah. And that's funny, because everybody mentioned that from, you know, from their hearts. Like, we really want to work together. And they're all saying, this is one way to actually be involved on a personal basis. So it's almost like based on their personal motivation. But then again, their professional ambitions or their professional goals can be also reached in that sense. And that is interesting. So it's actually like a different turnaround. I do this because I believe in this, and actually it's part of my work. Yeah. So, and that's a really nice movement.
It's very funny that you mentioned that, because that's kind of like a different mindset, almost like there's a new generation coming up. So I would like to thank you, Tess Rutgers, for your explanation here at Value Track. Thank you very much. That was Tess, and she mentioned this new mindset and this new way of looking at things, not only making profits and making money and doing things for your own business, but working together to solutions for world problems and seeing if you can do something intrinsic from yourself and your own wishes. So I have here at the table a person, Ruben Arendshorst, from this new generation,
yes,
a younger person here. Do you feel very young today with all these elderly people?
Yes, and also quite a small network I have at the moment, because everybody knows everybody and everybody wants to work together. So it's really nice to start up with a lot of crazy entrepreneurs with good mindsets. So it's really nice.
It's really nice. Because how did you get involved? How did you get to know the value track method and ideas?
Just because of my dad, actually. But we started off with our thesis with three students in Brussels for ID and innovation management at Erasmus.
Okay.
And that went very well. And afterwards, I had to do an internship. And I said to Tess, okay, what if we go further in personalized medicine? And actually, we built up everything for these sessions. And last week, the internship ended with
Because is it true what Tess said? It's something from your generation as well, that you feel this dynamic of working together and doing things for a greater goal?
Yeah, I think that's important, because you don't want to work for a company who don't support or just goes for the profit. You want to make impact, or the company have to make impact. And I think the mission and the vision of a company is important for the new generation to really connect and really get active, and I think that's important.
That's fun. Did you learn a lot these days?
Yeah,
I suppose.
Really nice.
Yeah, it's very good. Well, I hope that your generation can make it work, indeed, because there are some great threats, maybe not threats, but challenges for the future. Does the future scare you?
No, but because today is also scary something, and yesterday also. So
okay, so
I don't think it's gonna change.
It's a good energy and faith to solve
Let's
the problems.
Let's face it forward. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm very curious what the generation will do. But okay.
Too.
Well, thank you very much, Ruben Arendshorst, for your explanation, and have a great time here at Value Track Ideas from Europe. Thank you for being here.
Okay.